piece in our modern history.
Exactly. The last would have happened 600 years ago, and I'm sure they didn't have that kind of a crowd. No, the Holy Father was really saying farewell, and he said it very beautifully. He's a man of great courtesy and great culture, and it was that kind of a presentation. He thanked everybody. He expressed his own this humility comes out. This humility and courage. This extraordinary combination of virtues that Pope Benedict has.
Now, he did talk about the joy he felt after these 8 years as Pope. He also mentioned the difficulties. He talked about the gravity of his decision, about the novelty of this decision. He talked about having faced hard times also, that the church had been buffeted on agitated waters, but that he was sure that God would not allow this church to sink.
Right.
He clearly was referring not just to the usual challenges of the church, but to some of these scandals, some of the difficulties that have rocked this church. How do you think his papacy has dealt with them, and how does the next pope have to deal with these scandals?
Those are two very good questions. I think his papacy has dealt with them as well as it could. I think the instrumentalities that he had to deal with them, he's used them. He has been very forthright. He has himself been involved in so many of these things. He's done everything that he could do, I believe, to take care of this. I think as we go on into trying to figure out how best to serve God's people, how best to present the church in this world of ours, probably his successor is going to have to do what we did 50 years before Pope Benedict came, the aggiornamento of Blessed John the 23rd. The church needs an aggiornamento every few years.
What does exactly that mean?
It means to bring us up to date. The doctrines never changed, Blessed John would say. The doctrines never changed, but the way we present them has to change. The way we talk to people, because the people have changed. The people won't listen to the homilies of 100 years ago. They'll listen to the homilies of today if we find out how to approach them with the thoughts of today.
Well, let me ask you about that, because obviously the next big issue will be the conclave. Now, you are not going to be taking part in electing. You've reached an age whereby you can no longer vote.
Yes.
That's as kind as I can put it. You voted the last time around, and you know that so many of the cardinals have either been elevated by Pope Benedict XVI or by his predecessor, John Paul II. Conservative, traditionalists, at a time when at least American Catholics are saying that perhaps there needs to be a new direction, at least 46% of them saying, 51 saying that it should stay the same. What sort of reforms do you think should happen?
Well, you're asking me the $64 million question. But I think definitely we have to continue to keep involving the lay people. We don't have enough priests. We should have more priests. We must work on that. The Holy Father has done that. Bishops around the country have done that, around the world have done that. We haven't done it well enough. We must keep praying for it. We must keep attracting the young people, priests and religious too. We need wonderful religious women to continue the teaching function, the guiding function, the peacemaking function of our world.